So one gene controls one trait. So monogenic inheritance occurs when one gene controls one trait. So monogenic inheritance, this is basically the Mendelian inheritance. You remember the Mendel's experiments which he performed? So all those inheritance patterns, they are all monogenic inheritance. So in this type of inheritance, a child receiving a dominant allele from either parent. So if a child has a dominant allele, whether he received it from the father or the mother, the child will have the dominant form of the phenotypic trait. For example, in this case, so these are the parents. So capital T and small t, these are the parents. And which are the children of the first generation? So these are the children. Right? So if you look at the children, so even if a child receives one dominant allele from either parent, so here if you look at the first child, it has only one dominant allele, that is capital T. So even if it has one dominant allele, what would be the phenotype of the child? So the phenotype would be the dominant form, that is, this child is going to be tall. So in this case, I am taking the example of the pea plant, the experiment of Mendel. So you see, even if one dominant allele from either of the parent, the child is going to be tall, which is the dominant phenotype. So this is the basic characteristic of monogenic inheritance. Now, since it follows the Mendelian pattern of inheritance, it is also called Mendelian inheritance. So if you see now, the child will be short or dwarf only when it receives the dwarf allele from both the parents, right? So that is the basic characteristic of monogenic inheritance. That is, one gene controls the trait. For example, here that one gene is the gene for tall trait. So if capital T is there, then the overall phenotype is going to be tall. Whether it is capital T small t, or it is small t capital T, or it is capital T capital T. So it is dominated by this dominant allele. So the dominant allele rules, dominant allele decides what would be the trait. So when we say that one trait is controlled by one gene, we mean that the trait is controlled by multiple alleles of the same gene. For example, here if you see capital T, small t, these are multiple alleles of the same gene. So all of these are part of the same gene which talks about the height of the plant. Similarly, when you look at the other experiment of Mendel, where he worked with the round and wrinkled seeds. So they are also round and wrinkled, were two different alleles of the same gene which talks about the shape of the seeds. Now, purely Mendelian traits are a very small minority, as most of the traits that we see, mostly in the human body, they show incomplete dominance or codominance or contribution from multiple genes. So most of the traits in our body, they are basically polygenic. Very few traits in our body are monogenic. And one such example is the earwax gene. So let us look at the genetics of the earwax gene. Now, when we talk about the earwax gene, what could be the possible versions of this gene? So the earwax could either be dry or the earwax could be wet. Now, let us say that the wet earwax is represented by the allele capital W, and the dry earwax is represented by the allele small w. So these are the two alleles of the earwax gene. Now let's say that this is the father and this is the mother. So both of them will contribute one allele of this gene. So that is how it works. So for every gene, one allele comes from the father, one allele comes from the mother. So both of them will contribute one version of the same gene. So let us say that the father contributed capital W, that is wet earwax gene, and the mother contributed small w, that is the dry earwax gene. So what would be the genotype of your earwax gene? It would be capital W, small w. So when you look at it, How should it work? What should be the phenotype? That means what should be the actual trait that you have? So the actual trait that you have would be the wet earwax gene. So even though you have one capital W, one small w, that doesn't mean that your earwax would be somewhere between wet and dry. So it would not be an intermediate thing. It would be wet earwax because capital W is dominant over small w. And this is what we mean by monogenic inheritance, where one gene controls the trait. So here you see one gene, it is capital W which is controlling the trait. So capital W is presence of capital W is deciding that the earwax of this individual is going to be of wet type. So dry earwax is mostly found in Asians and Native Americans. So this was just an example to tell you that the pattern of inheritance of dry and wet earwax happens purely like the Mendelian pattern of inheritance. So this is one such example in human beings which follows